Hey, friend, this is Jennifer, and this is the Jennifer Allwood Show, the podcast for women who want to learn how to live an intentional life or build their creative business. I'll be giving you my very best business tips, bringing you interesting guests, giving you a daily dose of Jesus, and I'm committed to always keeping it real. Grab a cup of coffee and let's dive in. I'm so honored that you're here. Hey, guys, welcome back to the podcast, where I'm going to tell you to not give up. And I talked to you just a little bit about how we just hit 1 million downloads on our podcast. And it took a really long time, you guys, a really long time. An embarrassing amount of long time is what I've been thinking. And so I've been really hesitant to even share this podcast with you. But I have resolved and told you that I will always tell you the truth, pull back the curtain, give you the answers that you really are looking for, and not just paint the big, pretty Pinterest picture for you. And so I'm going to give you a behind the look at what it took to get to 1 million downloads. And it's important that you listen to this podcast, even if you never desire to have a podcast, because the point isn't 1 million downloads, okay? The point is we did not quit on the podcast. And so we're going to talk about that in just a second. But first, I want to give a quick shout out to Yolanda at a business called So Contagious. Okay. Here's what So Contagious said on one of my podcast reviews. She said, I listen to Jennifer's podcast over and over again. She helps you to check yourself, but in the kindest way possible. I felt that conviction. If I'm waiting for confidence, where is my faith? I love how she approaches her business and advice from a biblical perspective. She's the perfect coach for me. Well, first of all, Yolanda is So Contagious. Thank you for that. And thank you for being a member of my inner circle, which is, by the way, open as we speak. So listen, we only open this group twice a year. And my Creator's Inner Circle is the group where I teach business owners how to grow their social media and their email list in order to grow their business. Because I know that if a woman can grow her business, she can completely change her business. She can completely go home and change her family and generations to come. I know this because I've done this personally. And the reason my business has been so successful is because of the number of followers I have and the platform that I have grown. And people are trying to tell you that you can't still grow organically a following on social media without paying for ads. And that's crap, you guys. It's crap. You can still get followers. You can still get people to talk back. You can still grow an audience who will buy from you. And so I teach you how to do that in my Creator's Inner Circle. So if you are interested in learning every month how to do that, go to creatorsinnercircle.com and sign up. We're only open through September the 11th, I believe, at midnight is the last that you have to sign up. Is that right? September 11th? Whatever day Thursday is. That's the last day you got. And we won't be open again until 2020. We only open twice a year. And so Yolanda, I'm so glad that you're in the inner circle with me. It's my honor to coach you. And I just pray a blessing over your So Contagious business. And I love the name of your business because it's So Contagious, like S-E-W, because you sew. Isn't that cool? So friends that are listening to the podcast, I want you to go give Yolanda some love. Find her on social media. It's So Contagious. Okay. So let's talk about this podcast. So we hit 1 million downloads on this podcast in the last week, and we were so excited. And we gave away, there was a woman, well, we were giving away a gift for podcast subscribers. They had their choice of getting a Fitbit or an Apple Watch. So I don't actually know which one she selected, but we were so excited about hitting the 1 million download mark. And the reason I think we were so excited is because, you guys, it's taken so long to get to this point. We started my podcast 2.5 years ago. And I know a lot of you are going to be like, really? I only learned about her podcast in the last 6 months. Yeah, I know. I'm well aware. Because like nobody was listening for the first couple of years. And it wasn't for lack of efforts. I promise you, we were trying. I was putting out great content. If you go back, I mean, we have 131 episodes right now of this podcast, plus like 15 more of the Monday Fire, which are like the Jesus part of the podcast that I do on Mondays. And so, you know, we have a good 150 episodes right now. There's some good content. There's some meaty stuff. There's some great incentive and motivation and strategy and all of those things. But literally, it wasn't until just in the last 6 months that we were able to really like start seeing this huge acceleration in the number of downloads and the number of subscribers. We've been pretty consistently on the top 50 to 70 business podcasts in the world, which is super amazing. But it took 2.5 years to get here. And it's interesting because the entire time we've been doing it, and this is where the podcast is for you, I've been thinking, what are we doing wrong? Like, I see all these other people, they you know, put their podcast out into the world and they're in like the new and noteworthy whatever section of iTunes, like in a hot stinking minute. And then they are like at 1 million downloads in 90 days. And I'm like, how does that even happen? Oh, and by the way, they have a smaller audience than me. And I'm like, we're over here slugging it out week after week, not missing any, by the way. You know, one of my best strategies in business is that I refuse to let things slide. And I just, when I say I'm going to do something, like I'm all in. Does that make sense? And so for me, when I said I'm going to start a podcast, it wasn't like, well, I'll do an episode when I feel like it. I'll make sure I do a podcast only when it's not, you know, Christmas holiday, only when we don't have sick parents, all those things. Like, no, like we've done a podcast episode every week. And so when I've looked around and taken my eyes off of my own race, it's been really easy for me to get discouraged. I would see other people who are in my industry just like rising to the top so quickly. And I'm like, okay, either we're doing something really wrong or maybe this content is really bad. And I don't think my content is really bad. And I also don't think we're doing something really wrong. And so what I wanted to come on this podcast and just encourage you with this week is I think that there's somebody who's listening to this podcast right now who just needs to hear somebody say, you know what, girl, keep going. Please don't quit. I honestly think that you can't keep doing all of the right things and still come up with wrong results. Like at some point, things are going to take off. Now you may learn a lot. Listen, we're not doing the same thing on the podcast we were doing 2.5 years ago. We've learned how to package it differently. We've learned how to market it differently. We've learned how to tell people to tell people about the podcast differently. We've learned how to incentivize people to download it differently. We've learned how to, you know, link to it in the email and on the stories and stuff differently than what we did 2.5 years ago. So when I say you can't keep doing the right thing and get wrong results, that doesn't mean keep doing the same thing over and over and over and hope for different results. No, but that's not what I'm saying. But you can't keep doing the right thing. And I do believe us having a podcast is the right thing. And we show up week after week for you guys with good content and still get wrong results. And so I want to encourage those of you who are thinking, okay, it's taking way too stinking long. Listen, it's taken me way too stinking long too. There are plenty of people who are in my arena who went to $1 million in 10 months, who went to $10 million in a year. It took us, well, let's see. It took me 18 years to hit $1 million of revenue in my business. 18 years. 18 years, you guys. 18 years, because I started my painting business back in the year 2000. Now, if you're like, yeah, but the painting company was different. Okay. Well, I started selling online courses 4 years ago. So if you want, you can say, well, it took me 4 years to hit $1 million. And oh, by the way, we didn't just like hit a million, like we doubled that. We went from like 500,000 to over 2 million in just a few months. And so I'm saying that like not to boast. Please hear my heart. Please hear my heart. That is not to boast. It's just so that you who are listening are like, okay, now that I know what's possible. Jen was at this amount for a long, long time. And then she accelerated to this amount. Jen was like not getting a whole lot of podcast listeners for a long, long time, 2.5 years. And then all of a sudden things took off. I want to encourage somebody with that word today. The Bible even says in Zechariah 4:10, it says, do not despise small beginnings. Because what happens is, first of all, so many of us, we get so discouraged by the start and we don't even want to start, right? And then if we can find the courage to start, we'll go ahead and we'll start. But then it's like the slugging it out. It's like the messy middle. It's like the part where you're not really seeing the rewards yet. For everything that you're doing, for the hard work that you're doing, you're like, you've been planting seeds for a hot minute. And you're like, okay, Lord, ready for a little bit of harvest here by way of 1 million downloads on my podcast would have been nice. And you don't see that. It's that messy middle where people fall off, because sometimes it's easy to get started The start is sexy. The start feels exciting. In the start, you have tons of cheerleaders, people cheering you on, telling you how great it's going to be and how well your business is going to do. And it still feels great to get up early and, you know, and do all the things. And it still feels amazing to tell people about your new business. And then you get to this messy middle part where you're like, okay, now I'm just like going about the work of just slugging it out every day. And I'm still putting up podcast episodes that people aren't downloading. And I'm still trying to hit 1,000, you know, followers on Facebook. I'm still trying to sell my first course. I'm still trying to get this membership group going. I'm still trying to get my first sponsored content, but people keep telling me no. Listen, friend, I want you to know I can so relate to your frustration of things not happening quicker, but I'm begging you to please don't quit. If you still feel like this is what God is calling you to do, do not give up. You literally have no idea how close some breakthrough is. I love how Sandy Krakowski says, the day before a miracle looks just like any other day. You just have no idea. You have no idea. So keep going, my friend. Keep showing up and being consistent. Keep doing the thing that God has called you to do. Even if you're in that messy middle that's so discouraging, we're like, gosh, we're just slugging it out here. And I wonder if we should throw in the towel. And if you are feeling discouraged today, I have a podcast episode about discouragement. It was podcast episode number 81 and 95. I've done two podcast episodes on feeling discouraged. Go listen to either of those and be of courage. Be encouraged. Be encouraged, my friends. You have no idea how close your breakthrough could possibly be. And so I just want to thank you for those of you who have been listening to the podcast. Thank you for those of you who have forwarded it to your friends. And, you know, let me just tell you this too. Part of the reason we suddenly hit like some breakthroughs in the podcast is because I started asking you guys to tell people about it. I mean, it seems like such a like hitting myself in the head moment. I'm like, why wasn't I asking you sooner? And I don't know. I don't know. It didn't even occur to me. But I started asking you guys, will you share the episodes? There's three little buttons down in the corner. When you listen to my podcast, you can click on those three little dots and it'll say share. And you can copy the link and you can put it on your Instagram stories. You can forward it to your sister-in-law, Beth. You can take a screenshot and copy the link onto your Facebook and say, hey, is anybody else fighting discouragement? This was a great podcast episode for me. And so I literally started asking you guys to do that and you started responding. The other thing that we really did, if you're really wanting to get some strategy real quick, is we started doing double the amount of podcasts. When we weren't getting the results we wanted, and I was considering throwing in the towel at times, instead we doubled down. We doubled down. I knew I was supposed to be doing a podcast. I know where my podcast is about to go. I know that. God's already told me. And it's just a matter of how long it's going to take to get there. But the truth is, that sounds all fine and dandy, but when you're not seeing a lot of rewards in 2.5 years for your efforts, it's easy to go, okay, maybe I didn't hear God right. Maybe I'll just go ahead and push pause. And instead of pushing pause, we double down with double the content. So I want to encourage somebody today, please keep being consistent. Double down on your efforts if you need to. Keep doing the right thing. Don't get discouraged. You have no idea how close your breakthrough is. And I just want to tell you, thank you from the bottom of my heart, honestly, for those of you who have downloaded the podcast, who listen every single month, who share it with your people. I'm so, so honored. So, all right, friends, next week on the podcast, we are going to be interviewing my dear friend, Brian Dixon. Listen, Brian has a new book out called Start With Your People. You may have seen him on TV recently or on the interwebs talking about it. It's an amazing book. Not just for business people, but it's when you have things that you want to do in life, when you're not sure what to do, when you're not sure what your priorities should be, when it's about getting back to the basics and starting with the people who are closest to you and how to really make them a priority. And it's so good. Brian is such a smart person with an incredible testimony, somebody that should not be alive today. And we talk about that on the podcast. He was the only male that spoke at my All Women's Equipped conference back in April. And so I really trust him with the hearts of my audience. And so come back next week for that episode with Dr. Brian Dixon. And until then, I want you to go to creatorsinnercircle.com if you're a business person and sign up for my monthly coaching group. Now, I know that there's some of you right now who are like, oh, I've never been in a coaching group. And? I mean, I've never used DoorDash and I just downloaded in the app and I'm planning on doing it. You know what I mean? Like everybody does something for the first time. Well, I don't know if I could learn anything. Well, you certainly aren't going to know if you don't join. Well, I'm not sure that I have the time to devote to a coaching group. Well, I have about an hour's worth of content a week for you. Not all of it is mandatory. All of it is recorded. You don't ever have to be there live. And what I encourage people to do is to look at my coaching program like this beautiful buffet of business information and to just pick from the buffet that which you need. If you are not to the point where you're using Instagram stories or IGTV yet, why would you listen to a training on that? If you haven't even considered getting onto YouTube, don't listen to my YouTube training. If you're thinking, I just really need Facebook ads, then listen to that. But we've got a smorgasbord of trainings for you. I don't like people using the excuse, I don't know if I have the time. You can't tell me that I don't know if I have the time and yet I want to grow my business so bad. I'm willing to do anything to do that. On the other hand, you can't, those two things don't go hand in hand. We all have huge pockets of time. Seriously. How much time did I spend last week watching Yellowstone, the new series? Also, just a little forewarning, lots of adult content there, cussing and the likes. And if you don't have 3 days of your life to give up to the series, please don't even start watching it because it will suck you right on in. Hashtag truth. But we all have the same amount of hours in a day. And at some point you may have to decide that investing in your business and the future of your family is more important than watching The Bachelor. At some point, you may have to decide that investing in your business and your family's future is more important than going out with friends on a Friday night. You just might. Like, I'm not saying you can't ever, but at some point, like, you have to determine, am I going to make this a priority or I'm just going to keep talking about making it a priority? Am I actually going to grow this business and learn from someone who can take me to A to B much quicker than what I can go on my own? Or am I just going to keep talking about how I want to grow my business? Because there's a huge difference, friends, in people who are willing to put their money where their mouth is and invest in learning quicker how to do things that can take a fraction of the time. There's a huge difference between that person and the person who just keeps yakking their lips. And I say that with all due respect, for real. But I cannot even handle the people who are all talk, for real. Like, I've heard you say that you want to grow your business for years now, and I call BS on it, friend. I'm not talking to any of you, by the way, but you know how, like, there's other people who, like, they have all these dreams and you never see them take one step in the direction of it. Well, at the end of the day, at some point you may have to put your money where your mouth is and invest in the thing that you're wanting to do. So I want you to get over to creatorsinnercircle.com right now. Sign up, and you're going to say, oh, it's $67 a month. Yes, it is. And you're going to spend that at the movies this weekend. Yes, it's $67 a month, which is exactly half of what your phone bill is. Yes, it's $67 a month, and you're probably spending that more on Netflix and Amazon Prime this month. Yes, it's $67 a month, and it should probably be priced 4 times that a month. And I'm not even joking. We have well over 2,000 entrepreneurs already in this group, so I already know what a couple of you are saying. Well, I want to have one-on-one access to Jennifer. Well, not at $67 a month, friend. I love you. There will be other ways you can go deeper with me. You're going to have to go through the $67 a month channel though first. Does this make sense? I hope that this makes sense. Right now, I'm giving you a call. By the way, none of this is on my notes. Mel, if you're listening right now, I know I'm going completely off plan. But listen, I need you to know that I have sat where you are. 5 years ago, I am right where you are. How do I do this business in the online space? How do I make it so I never have to go back to a client's house? How do I change what life looks like for my family? How do I change it? What can I do different? And once I got a taste of how using social media could result in sales, oh, my eyes were like so opened. And then I was like, okay, if I've got this many followers and I'm making this much, what happens if I double my followers? Can I make double as much? Or what happens if I can just take the followers I already have and just really figure out what it is they want from me and figure out how to sell to them? Oh, I'm telling you what, everything changed. Everything in my business has changed in the last 5 years because of my social media. And I want to teach some of you how to do that too. And if you are somebody who's really willing to make the sacrifice to do that, to pay for it, to spend some time every week working on it, then I want you in my group with me, for real. And it's my heart's desire to teach. And by the way, it's also my responsibility it's a holy responsibility, I believe, to teach people what I know so that they can grow their business. And so then your next question is going to be, well, then why is it $67 a month? Well, friend, I teach you all day long on these podcasts. I've got 131 episodes where I've taught you for free. I teach you on Facebook Lives for free all the time. I hope that you'll look at what I've already taught you for free and think, holy crap, I wonder what her teaching is like when I'm paying for it. I wonder how much deeper she'll go when I actually invest in it. You know, there's times when I get really irritated when I think about how my parents didn't pay for my college. I am just going so far off topic and off notes now. Forgive me. There's sometimes when I get so annoyed that I had to pay. I went to my first year of college on a scholarship and I blew my scholarship. So then when I went back to college, I had to pay out of pocket. But let me tell you something. When it was my money and I had to pay for it, college suddenly meant so much more to me. I was no longer just jacking around because now the money was literally coming out of my checkbook and I had better take it seriously. And for some of you, it's not even so much that you're getting into my training. It's just the fact that when you pay for something and it hits your credit card every month for $67, you're like, I'd better take it seriously. Money is actually going out the door. My family's going to want to see some sales because of this. I'm actually investing in something. I guess I better do the work. Yeah, you best. Sometimes that's how we have to trick ourselves into doing hard things, is by actually investing in something. I'm done with my rant. Some of you are ready. Come over to creatorsinnercircle.com. Join me in the group. Can you get out at any time? Yes, you can. But if you're already wondering how soon you can quit, please don't join. For the love, for real. We've got a really low quit rate that hovers right around 5 to 6% every month. I don't want you in there just to quit. If you're already wondering how to get out, do yourself a favor and do not join. And I mean that. Because you're already, you've got a quitting mentality. And I just can't have that in my group. Like literally, we've got a group of women who are all moving in the same direction, like a stinking army. Who's the woman that does the, she's the Mockingjay. What's the name of that movie? Come on, menopause brain. You know what I'm talking about. The movie where she's the Mockingjay. And there's like, she's got like an army of people and they're all headed in the same direction. They're all fighting for the same thing. That's what my Creators Inner Circle is like. And by the way, we're not all creatives. We have dog walkers, real estate people. We have organizers. We have people who are selling skincare products, bath lotions. It's not for just creatives. It's for people who have created a product. They're a creator of some sort. They've created a business. But we're all trying to move in the same direction, like taking over an industry and monetizing the heck out of it. And making money doing things that historically we have shot ourselves in the foot with and made close to nothing. I have a whole like gang of artists in here who are retiring their husbands, who are able to now pay for family vacations, who are buying cars with cash. Don't mess that up by coming in my group wondering when you can quit. I love you, but that's not the type of people I want in here. So, whew, Lord have mercy. I just lost time just a little bit now. So if you're ready, though, I'll see you in there. Creatorsinnercircle.com. We're only open up twice a year, and so we won't be open again until 2020. I'll see you next week with the episode with Brian Dixon on Start With Your People. Until then, stay creative. Bye-bye. Hey, friend, thank you so much for listening to the podcast again this week. I'm so honored that you're here and that you just listen week in and week out and that you share the Jennifer Allwood Show with your friends and family. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Hey, don't forget that you can subscribe to the podcast on iTunes, or if you're an Android user, go download the Stitcher app and you can subscribe there so that you know every single week when a new episode releases. Also, if you have any time to leave us a review, these reviews are super important in getting guests for the show and sponsors for the show. And so we'd appreciate it if you have just a second to leave us a review. That would be amazing. Thank you guys again for being here. And until next week, stay creative.